Hey everybody! So today is day 3 of NaNoWriMo, and I just wanted to address a question that I've gotten quite frequently. How do I find the time to write so much? And I wasn't really sure what video I was going to do today, but then I watched a video this morning by Emma's Books. She was talking about how she finds time to read books. And in that video, she kind of explained all the different ways that she's found the time to read more books, and that included like audiobooks, which she said helped her to go through a lot more books, like during her commute or while she was doing the dishes. And so yeah, this video was kind of inspired by her video. You can check out her channel here. It's gonna be here somewhere. So when I'm in like my novel writing mode, I can write for like 3 to 5 hours per day. There was a time that I could write 10 plus hours a day and crank out 10,000 plus words. But as it is right now, I do not have the time nor the resources to continue writing in that fashion. And so I've had to kind of compensate by adjusting my schedule and finding the time that works best for me to do my writing in the most efficient way. And just remember, this video is just how I write. I'm not trying to say this is the best way to do it. I'm just saying that this is for me. This is what I do when I'm in novel writing mode. So yeah, 3 to 5 hours a day, that's like the time that I'll allot to myself. And it takes a lot of discipline, first of all. When I do it, I'll wake up around 5:30 or 6 o'clock, and I'll be out the door by 6:30 or 7. And I'll go to a coffee shop or Panera Bread or Starbucks or wherever I'm living, like the most convenient place to write. Where I am right now, that's Panera Bread and Starbucks. In all the years that I've been writing, I've kind of switched between those two when I'm in my hometown. When I lived in Pittsburgh, there was a coffee shop in the South Side called Delaney's Coffee, where I actually wrote the entire second book of my series, Resonance. That would be Resonance. And when I was there, I would sit up on the second balcony of the coffee shop because it was 2 floors and it was awesome. I'd sit right on the edge of the overhang and I'd just be typing away at my little computer. And I did that for 86 days straight. And at the end, voila! I had this bad boy, Resonance. And by writing every single day, by waking up at 5:30 or 6 in the morning and getting to my writing place around 7 o'clock in the morning, it's very refreshing. You're one of the first people in your town to wake up, and you can take that drink of coffee. I'm up to 5 now, guys, for NaNoWriMo. And honestly, one of my favorite things to do that early in the morning is watch the sunrise. A lot of you who follow me on Tumblr got to see me as I was writing book 3, Pyrrhelid. And you know that I was to Panera Bread almost every single day, and I would sit there with my headphones on, jamming out. And where I would sit, the sunrise was directly to my right, and I would just be able to watch the sun come up, and it was just so relaxing and just so peaceful. And it was just one of the best ways to start the day. And you do this every single day, and it just becomes a habit for you. Doing that every day tells your brain, hey, I'm about to start writing, you're gonna have to start thinking up some plots. It just gets you in this writing mode so that each and every day you wake up with a fresh outlook, and even when you have a bad day of writing, you can teach yourself, hey, tomorrow will be better. And that happened to me a lot. There were days I didn't know what the heck I was doing. I would delete pages of stuff and then retype it all. And at the end of the 3 to 4 or 5 hours that I was there, I'd be like, oh my gosh. Because sometimes writing just sucks. Not every day is going to be an awesome typing day. Some days you're just going to sit there staring at the ceiling. Making that your routine is just a nice way to like meet people, you know, you have something to talk about in the morning. At the same time, it's a time to be you. It's really early in the morning. You have zero obligations. But when you do this every single day, you build up this discipline. And even though some days you're only going to write a couple hundred words, and some days you'll get 2,000, 3,000. The point of writing every single day, or as often as you can, and doing it at the same time every day, if possible, is that That is your time to write. And for me, that time to write was 7 in the morning to 10 in the morning. Sometimes it was like 6 to 9. And what does that do? It lengthens your day. You woke up early, you got your writing done, now the rest of your day is yours to enjoy. Everyone else is just getting their day started at 9 or 10 in the morning, and on the weekends, even later. So by gaining those 3 hours in the morning, you're giving yourself the entire day to do anything else but write because you already finished writing. For me, I could go through the rest of my day and just not feel like guilty that I wasn't writing because I had already built in that time and I knew tomorrow at the exact same time I would have 3 hours to write. It just became a system. It worked. I finished the book in about 100 days, and in like 2 weeks, I'm gonna rip that thing to shreds. It's gonna have so much red pen all over it, you'd think I used like 13 pens. These are, in fact, the 13 pens that I used to edit Embassy. Some people actually bought me red pens for my birthday when I was editing Embassy. You know who you are. Thank you. In fact, red pens are like the best birthday gift I can possibly get because I always finish writing books around my birthday. So if I have red pens stocked up, that's like, I can just get going. Don't have to worry about, oh my gosh, do I have a red pen? Because I already know I got some for my birthday. So yeah, that's how I find time to write. I do it in the morning. It works for me. That's my schedule. It's my routine. Right now during Nano, I'm not doing that because I'm not like taking Nano seriously right now. I did just finish a book and I'm still just not in a writing kind of mode because I'm still like thinking about book three and tweaking plot things in my head. So for me, Nano is more Thinko. So the project I'm working on right now, which is actually book four, I'm just taking my time. I'm not taking it seriously enough right now to write a complete draft of it. And I have to find time to read too. So yeah, how do you make time to write? What's your schedule? How long do you give yourself to write every day? Leave your responses in the comments below, and I'll see you guys next time. As always, if you could, go check out my books, Embassy and Resonance. They're futuristic science fiction. You can find the link to them below in the description. And you can also check out the website for them, www.experiencedeleona.com, where you'll find lots of behind-the-scenes content that will help enhance your experience as you read the books. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe, leave a like, leave a comment, and happy Nano. See ya!